In this lecture, we are going to install Solaris operating system on our virtual machine. So before going that, we just go to the setting, then storage option. You can see there is an empty disk. Now we are going to choose our ISO image which we downloaded earlier. If you will not find in the list, you can go to the path where you downloaded. So as I am downloaded in my state directory, selected and click OK. Now this is time we need to start our virtual machine, power on, just click on start. So new window open. Now our virtual machine is started. So you can go step by step installation process for Solaris Intel on our virtual box. So as you can see, it's loading. It will take little time. So we need to choose the keyboard language, which is default on 27. We just hit enter, or we can write 27, or it depends on you which language you want. So I just write 27 and hit enter. Then you have to choose English, which is the default keyboard layout. Now it is a configuring devices phase, so it will take little time. You can see this error, ignore it, just write one and hit enter, because we are going to install Oracle Solaris option. You can see above 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 options. So we are going to choose first one and hit enter. So this error is only virtual box error, not operating system. So ignore it. End of this lecture, I will just show you how to solve this error, just for your information. But ignore in this installation phase. So at the end, you will see the welcome to Oracle Solaris interface. Just hit on F2 and you can see discovery method of our disk. There are two types, local disk and iSCSI. So we are going to choose local disk, and you can see there is a 20 gig which we assigned to that virtual machine in previous lecture. So click F2. Here you can see the type of the disk, size, device and VBox. So this is Oracle Solaris, can be installed on the whole disk or GPT partition on the disk. So we are going to use the entire disk in this installation. Use the entire disk option, then F2, and this is the phase where we need to use our computer name. So we are going to remove this default Solaris name. We will use SOL1 computer name and select a wired network connection to configure. So there is one default interface and there is no network. So we'll go with the default interface installation, click F2. And there is the network configuration methods. There are two type of network configuration methods, through DHCP or static. We choose static, configure the interface with the static IP address. So hit F2. Now you can write IP address based on your network. So I'm going to use 192.168.1.20. And you can choose or change network mask and default gateway. In our case, it is 192.168.1.1. Hit F2. Then there is an indication of the DNS name services. So configure DNS or do not configure DNS. So we will choose do not configure DNS. Hit F2. And this is the alternative name services. So we choose none, then hit F2. Then this is a region that contains your time zone. So I will choose Asia. And then location that contains your time zone. So I will choose United Arab Emirates. This is my current zone. Hit F2. This is the language setting, so we choose English. This is the language territory, we choose United States. And this is our date and time. You can set your date and time. So I'm going to choose default. Later we can change the date and time. Hit F2. This is the keyboard. I choose US English. Then we have to set root password. So just set the root password. At least one number in your password. So it give me message root password must contain one digit. So I'll rewrite the password. F2, hit F2. Then this is a setting. If you want to add your support account to this installation to get Oracle updates for your operating system, you can choose. Otherwise, you can use anonymous account for email. Hit F2. And this is your installation summary. We have computer name, network, time zone and other configuration. So we have to click on F2 to install. Now our installation process is started, so it will take 15 to 20 minutes or more. As you can see on the screen, so at the end our installation is complete. As you can see the completion message, The installation of Oracle Solaris has completed successfully. You can see later if you want to see the log file of installation on this path. So hit reboot. It will take little time to reboot. As please note that if because I installed GUI after the installation of this operating system, so I will show you how to install the desktop environment GUI interface after text-based installation. So our installation is completed. We log in through the root. In next lecture, we will learn how to set up IP addresses on the virtual machine.